Leadington side, who met dancers with Bertini and Butterworth, and it's their collection of the dance that Sharp published in Morris Books. And we will meet that this afternoon. It was based on the information of two people who were known as masters or new recording captains or squires of the Morris, or the word scribe, I think it was known there. And they had a particular style of dancing. The play with little bits to help you understand that, but appreciate that today is not day to actually go away saying, I can do 19 something or other version, so and so. It's actually meet these things, appreciate the point of the tradition that you represent. And if you want to do any of these traditions for a staff group, then you've got a selection to make on the whole thing. Deciding what you want to do in Morris is probably what might be going to be for.
Thank you.
of weird ways of doing it. I have to ask you today, when I explain the way I would like to see it done, the way I'd like to see it done in the next hour and a half. But if you have other ways of doing it, you might keep them to yourself. First thing, basic double step, we all understand what I mean by that, don't we? Yeah, we do have a common language, don't we? Come on, let's have some music, please. Back to old classic moments.
jump to face back the original way.
Right, move your arm.
Now, do the same thing and bring your arms in as you go back, right? With that, you should turn more than half a turn. Right? In other words, the moment of inertia on your relatively lightweight arms has a significant effect on making a turn for a certain degree of effort. And it's also true of your leg. Right? This is in fact the bringing the arm to the leg frame, that swing edge. Coming in is decreasing your raw inertia. It should help you overcome the friction of your feet on the ground, which some of you have got. Really, it would be nice if you were off the ground in the happening. Can we have a little bit of 1, 2, 3 up, 1, 2, 3 half hook? 1, 2, 3 up, 1, 2, 3 half hook. I've got a little hook hold in my favourite paper if you might know what to do with the rest of music.
Thank you.
Comes as a walk round face to face until we're about shoulder to shoulder facing our own face. Keep going, mate. And then you do your hook forward, turn. Your right foot, even though, regardless of what your stance is, right to left, so that in fact it's in front of the other. You don't turn the body more than you have to, right? And the side step hand movement is half of the double, right? Thank you. Drop everywhere. It also means thing is that as you grip, you grip it on the actual contact. And there's no bounce. And what's more, if your partner forgets to hit and you grip it in the right place, there's no follow through. Right, how to save you for a second. different people, different sources, had different ideas about how the stick tapping was done. Some of these can be explained by the fact that there are dancers who actually dance with more than one side and more than one captain, that is, and therefore the captain had his own view on how it should be done. In fact, if you don't believe that people have some of their ability, when I met the two Salter boys, in their 70s, it was a bit good, they said the foreman of the Bidford side didn't tell them what the stick tapping was, even when the dancers started. He sort of chose what to do when he got to the chorus. And if you couldn't follow, he then did it again, just to rub it in. And the audience used to think that's great. They seemed very high on the first. We weren't due to do that today, I'm sorry to say. People would just see it as something that I didn't do, you know. Right, so what are we going to do? Place.
Thank you.
dancers in a Cox or Morris. One or two places like Annabrin, Stanton Harcourt, that had more than their share, as it were, special line. But on the whole, two or three dancers sitting in the column, and even then, strip dancers had a hand-tapping version of it. So quite clearly, people either forgot their stick or were too much trouble. Or, as a conjurer, Aaron Taylor and his generation, since there wasn't any stick dancers, and the generation after the probably did do a stick dance, because at Chippingham they have a stick dance called the longer stick dance. Things come and go. Things were not actually so fast and concrete as you may sometimes imagine. But let's put our sticks there in there.
Thank you. Thank you.
and then you're facing and hooked to rule. Then the other shoulder. 1, 2, 3, hop. Back. 1, 2, 3, hop. Hook to rule. That's the other one.
Yeah.
slow capers in them. First one, Glory Shearer, the leapfrog dance. Glory Shearer is short for Glorious Year, a song, but don't be worried about that. There are a number of issues that go with this dance, of course. It was one of the first that was collected, then recollected, and then they were told they were doing it wrong, and things like that. It's a lot of drama issues coming through. The first thing is the chorus, trace across. It's a side set and half a chorus, only there are endless interpretations on how you actually do it. The early generation of collectors had a sidestep, a variety of those, and a jump in half pay. And then the traveling Morris finally were given sidesteps and repeated that pay. Right. What I'm going to do, just for this workshop, is put all the varieties into the one dance.
Da,
and then you nodded onto it, right? Those people that used to put the brim in a hat in respect for people usually got presented by their friends with a hat with a brass brim, so they weren't expected to fall from the head of a hat. But certainly it was always, you put your hand up and dump it before you. I have never seen anybody actually do that, I might say. My grandfather used to say very good things about people who show respect to their betters. He didn't believe he had any. He met my grandfather, you argue about it. Right. So it's one ring of bell. There's slow capers. Then we have this basic problem that in fact what was collected from the old men is not the same as from the young men. And also, I said to you earlier on that one of the problems was in explaining, for example, the upright cable of the cross cables, each man who saw it being explained has a different impression on how it was. Right? From cross, with a big emphasis on the first one rather than the second one, to one, two, three. What we're going to try and do is to learn the Bacon way of doing it, right? So everybody, cross, and that's a tap. Going up behind. So the heat up and bring up the footage of her off the third one. One, two, three. So we have a choice. The next one is Archie Green. Well, I said the one that probably comes first at the back. Everybody, put your right toe back and don't lean forward. Right? Don't lean forward. Right, together. Side to the people going over not sideways on, because not until then, sorry, ladies. That's the way you get your head banged and things like this, and you're not so keen to come over. It also goes with the fact that the old game of leapfrog, which, as far as I know from my kids, they don't actually do anymore. Hold on. If somebody goes there and jumps over, people said, what's that?
I think
it is a part of the unconscious culture. The leapfrog stepping is like that in the upright chamber, cross, cross, and then two jump. I'm going to try it, and the gentleman behind you will. You'll go there, right? Ready? Cross, 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 jump, and over. Then he goes there immediately.
Oh,
at the top, in the second middle, then 1, 2, 3, 4. If you're particularly athletic, you minimise the bend. But I do assure you that to actually go with someone standing upright, out of practice while you're above. Right.
facing that way. And then turn on the way.
Yeah, it works.
Yeah.
It's also a tune balance of nerve, it's also William. Do the same tune again. Face up.
We're in the learning program.
When they were taught Pennington in in the old style of doing Headington, when, you know, they actually taught a very large boom. So I've always left the sneaking feeling that in fact they were just overdoing it for the purposes of
GSS.
So, Ned. Will you start playing a bit? Now, it's six bars of double center foot up and cross back foot up. Hold it face to face, that's exactly the same. Rounds, goes halfway round, 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3. Now face across. When you've got. Give me one place more, that's right. And face across for your cross back set, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And come back.
Easy way.
Easy way in. 1, 2, 3, and 1 minute. Face across the back. Halfway. Okay.
Not this time, right?
You face across. When you do a half pace at the same time, do a half pace, walk half pace. Face across. Across back. So, round, so this early version of the position, it's like that. There's a galley halfway in half jib only, back to back and whole jib are done with cross back steps, and reins and the hay are done like this. Right? You face across. Now, the next thing is to learn, and you come back to your side again. The sidestep hand movement, you put your arm up past your left arm up past your left ear. And then really do mean that way. You're not a policeman with the traffic as they used to, right? It's help, I'm dreaming. Right? And just do the twist up there.
Right.
groups that came over the meeting, basically members of Tiddy's side. And side before the First War, signed to continue in the village after the First War, because he died in the war and stuff. And I'll say my major contact was Ralph Honeybone, who had been his backman during the war, and who went on to be a scholar at Oxford, and then became a member of what was called the headquarters display team in the early 20s, because so many of the originals were killed in the war. And he settled at Evesham, and he actually married one of Sharp's peers, somebody who actually paid his classes. And when I knew him, he was a very, very active man, very active, and so was his wife for that matter. And they had strong memories, and they worked very hard for the EFTSS in that part of the country. But there were other people. There's Mrs. Edwards at the post office in Ascot, who could dance as a girl. They were big sizes. There's Albert Townsend, who was a very good dancer until he fell out of a tree. I've seen him once, he'd fall out of a tree and really didn't get up. He was confined his bed. But there are a number of people of that sort who could get. So I'm fairly sure about that sort of interpretation. Now the next thing that Mary Neon Clive Carey also ran across from there. Bear in mind that Tiddy lived in Ascot, he knew the Mosses, the Voss brothers, who were the old dancers, and so on, and got the contact with Shire. But Mary Neon invited Benjamin Moss up to London, and they had some further contact and so on. Now, not much material survives from collecting all her people. When I say all her people, Mrs. Tuke collected the abdomen for her. She was the treasurer of the WSPU. Jeffrey Toy and his brother, who became noted conductors and playwrights and producers of plays and so on, they also noted things like this. You know, there are all sorts of people in the artistic world who got involved and so on. But not much of anything, but there is a document about sort of notes and comments. She obviously prepared a brief for some meeting or other in the period of the rounds of Sharp, and where she'd gone through saying, well, like Headington, but this is what the various dancers did, you know, and they're all different, so which one's traditional sort of music. But under Ascot, she made, well, made a point, there's a point about the dancing, and one of the points made was in fact that they put the galley halfway through all the figures. So now we're picking up again. That doesn't mean foot up, we'll keep our foot up. But we've done half jib, then we're going to do whole jib and back to back like that. And the one that's going to be different is rounds. We'll just walk rounds. Going three double steps. One, two, three, and one, two, three, and one, two, three, and galley. Then we're going to get back in one, two, three, and one, two, three, and one, two, three, and jump. We're back to music. Only galley left. Right? So, after lunch, we're going to meet some dancers where, in fact, that rule becomes important. It's a great idea, in other words. It's no problem we're going to meet all those Galileans. Whatever else you do. But let's then try the same dance, but with these different figures. We're going to end on rounds, which caper up this time.
Teaching to Bath City a number of traditions that nobody was doing.
in successive years, we did Duckington, Stanton Harcourt, and Ascot. And I remember we had the great pleasure, nice pleasure, of dancing Ascot in Ascot under Wychwood. To, I can't remember now, if it was three or four people, which was twice the size of where we had in Stanton Harcourt. We had fun in there. But again, like everybody else, they didn't do it the way I taught it. Now, I taught it and then they got it right through the meeting. So there was also a Bath City interpretation, a slight different line, which then members of Bath City took, like to Bristol, and on to Kent's men. Right? So there's another thread of, is it where an interpretation of tradition would exist. That's not to say that I personally love all I see. Coventry's great, Kent's great, so is and so on. They all do it very well, but all differently. Now, there is one team I haven't mentioned yet, and that is my local friends, John Bryler, who probably is not unknown to most people though, but he, at the start of Couple, he came across one night and said, I want to learn a new tradition, what have you got? So we basically taught him Ascot. And I hadn't realised in those days that John's not actually that reliable in remembering things. And he taught it to Cuphill with some nice subtle differences. again, Cuphill still dances the way they did 25 years ago, and it's beautiful. So none of them are wrong, they're all just slightly different. Right? And you'll find it. Now, how are they different? Well, Bristol, you'll notice when Bristol dance, that in fact, when it comes to the handlings, instead of this, you know, with an emphasis that way. It's an emphasis this way. It pulls towards you when they do this. Right? So, they all have invented dance and so on, and I say the differences are, in a sense, quite minor between interpretations. But if I mention this size, which we actually want to pick this tradition up and carry on with it, it's actually worth, if you can, seeing one of these other sides in the way they interpret it. Realise it's not the only interpretation, but it's quite an interesting way of doing it. Now, if we get your sets up again, we'll do this dance once more. Just slightly different. I find the music and the stepping is in fact the way that with the arm movements, you can let the handkerchief float up, so that the handkerchief does the flip off the beat, rather nice, when you actually have to do that. Now I know that has grown up, like, you know, the idea that somehow Ascot is a long sweep, and certainly Ring of Bells in New York do it that way, it's a big long, and I have video of them doing it. Somebody else, you should. Knowing you were here. Right. As I say, yes, I had the pleasure of teaching dancers to Ring of Bells in New York in a dance studio about 8 or 9 floors up in the skyscraper. We were fairly near the bottom of the skyscraper. It was rather nice. But what was so wonderful about it is you ever can dance occasionally in a dance studio with mirrors all the way around. It really is a sanitary lesson to see how bad you are, how far away from what your foreman wants you're actually dancing. It is very, it's very important. And I had a problem with this particular case. I got so used to people being careless, and I got tripped up by, in fact, everybody was doing exactly what I did. And I said, what did you do that for? I said, I learned many years ago, back in the early 60s, when Leslie Nichols said to me, I never thought to see six Roy Domitz dancing. I decided at that point I was never going to have people copy what I did. Right, then, the course, face across, short slice of each way, 1, 2, half pay, Give her half of it. And you've got a bit of music left over, so face across, I will have four plain cables.
We all same dance.
The same dance, yeah. They do the same thing back to place. One, two, three, half a. Right? You can all do that, can't you? Except And the Arctic bees, right, are
in retrospect,
two double-sided
frames.
people at Leadfield, based on Morris, they said Ascot was the next generation of Leadfield, next generation of field tank. Right? Now, it was a very large piece of short sort you had to take to believe it. But it was said to one of the collectors, one time it was, that in fact the people at Ascot had trouble getting on with the galley. You see? Yes, that's right. Yeah. And they say, put it in this most stupid place than that. You can't believe oral tradition as much as you would like. You only believe when it's the only thing you've got. Right? But it being the next village to Leadfield, it's not surprising that some people choose to see field tank in the way they want to interpret the dance. And that's what we're going to do in the half hour here, right? Now we've done the two courses with playing capers, we're going to pick up the courses with the RTBs. So, Thank you.